That one, don't take away my hand. And as we get closer to the top of the hour here in Wikieup, Arizona, the top of the hour being 10 o'clock at night, or 2200, it is time to wind down to ensure your road traveling goes as smooth and comfortable as possible. Just like a set of Pirelli tires. Whether you are traveling north towards Vegas or south towards Phoenix, you can be sure that as long as you stay on US 93, my voice will be coming out of your stereo. You are tuned to 97.1 SPR, The Spur.
Yippee-yay, there'll be no wedding bells for today. I got spurs that jingle, jangle, jingle.
Jingle, jangle.
As I go riding merrily along.
Before I go live again on this radio station, I think I should inform you, whoever is listening to this recording, that over the past several days, there have been some strange calls coming in. There is not much in this town of Wikieup other than the landmark being that of Snoopy on a rocket and a diner adjacent to a Chicago-style restaurant. Lately, however, my night shift has turned into an Orson Welles-inspired nightmare fictional story. If only that were truly the case, though. At night, this desert feels different than it did once before, and the sounds of this desert are otherworldly, with the howls of coyotes notwithstanding. Perhaps this ominous feeling and these strange calls will cease. Back to going live in 3, 2... That was Kay Kaiser with Jingle, Jangle, Jingle. While the full moon makes its way higher in the night sky, doing you drivers a favor by illuminating your surroundings, I want to take a moment to enlighten you about the small town Wikieup and the good eatins around this small corner of the United States. If you are passing by tomorrow, check out Cool Water Cafe and order up a slice of the mystery pie after you devour a good hearty breakfast of eggs, toast, and hash browns, or anything else you fancy on the menu. And be sure to tell Brenda thank you, for she keeps those pies coming. All right, I've got someone on the line that wants to chat a bit. His name is David. What's up, David?
Hey, Al. I was wondering if you could play me some Sinatra after I get off the line here.
Will do.
But first, I have to tell you about my experience a few nights ago. You see, I took my car in to get looked at as it was making a funny chirping noise with the belt and all that. You know, it was like chirp, chirp, chirp. And I figured they could also check for anything else it may have needed for preventative maintenance, as I am visiting my cousin up in Grand Forks here soon. But as I was walking home, because I dropped off my car, honest to God, I saw a flying saucer. Call me crazy, Al, but this was a pure high flying saucer, and I had just to take a big old bite out of it once I saw it flying in the window, because it was Alex throwing up a big flat pizza dough saucer, preparing it for a lovely family. And I went in to get some pizza myself.
Sounds delicious, David. Where's
this
pizza joint?
Oh my goodness, it was filled with some pepperonis, and I had some hamburger meat on it, and some onions and red peppers. And I think it was called a Supreme Pizza. It reminded me when I was in the car and I took some leave and went to New York to get some pizza.
All right, David. Well, thank you very much for calling in. And how about I play us some of that Sinatra that you asked for?
Yes, sir.
And I do want to say, any of you veterans or current active duty service members that are listening to this radio station out here in Wikieup, Arizona, I tip my hat to you as you keep that flag flying right above our studio out here in the desert. And thank you very much for your service. So let's go ahead and get that Sinatra rolling.
Blue moon, you saw me standing alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own.
I had to cut David short because once he starts talking about himself, he won't stop, and I could tell he was indirectly making fun of the locals with his flying saucer story, as some callers have been reporting some dark figures in the desert hills out here. All I see outside the studio window is some typical wildlife. While I think David can be pretty funny, small doses of him is necessary. I don't need him taking up much airtime. I want to keep the mood light as best I can because this town sure could use it lately. Playing smooth, classy music is probably the best way to achieve that small town halcyon that was present a few months back. Now, I want to mention William. William is a town local, and he is a very astute man. I bring him up because 2 nights ago, he had called in and he described what he saw in his bathroom mirror. He said, for a split second, right as he turned on the light, he saw a pale face with darkened eyes and long stringy black hair, as if it was his own face. It was on his body, but then he said that the reflection looked just like him after that split second. I don't know what to make of that. And the thing is that William, he's just not the type of person to make that up. I've known him for several years. Now I don't know what to think. Of my own. That was Blue Moon by Frank Sinatra on 97.1 SPR, The Spur. Now I know y'all have been enjoying these classy songs, and trust me, we've got plenty more songs to play. Folks, I just saw several police cars with their lights on driving north on 93, so please be careful out there on the roads and drive responsibly. Be sure you utilize the road appropriately, meaning that the left lane is for passing only, especially out there on the interstate. Now, I want to go ahead and let caller number 2 go ahead and start talking here on the line. I know I've had you on standby here for a few moments. What's your name and what do you got for us here?
Hey Al, my name is Brian, and I just want to say first off that I'm a big fan of the show.
Oh,
I love the music you play as it gets me through the night.
That's great to hear. I do what I can.
I really wanted to call to have someone to talk to in order to get something off of my chest. And maybe someone else has experienced this same thing too. Sorry, I'm kind of nervous. This is the first time I've ever called into a radio station, but
it's all right.
Okay, so first off, how do I start this?
I'm breaking your cherry, I get it.
See, I ended up calling it off with my girl yesterday.
Oh no!
The reason being is because I've been freaked out, man. So I've been waking up in bed with her as she would stay over.
Ooh.
But I would wake up in a panic.
I see.
The weirdest thing is that I wouldn't be able to move my body. I would feel paralyzed and stiff, as if I broken every single bone in my body. But
oh, ouch.
The weirdest thing is that as I would feel paralyzed and I would be in this state of panic,
yeah,
I would feel as if my girlfriend was staring at me.
Whoa. Ew.
And
freaky.
There was one night especially, I was able to peek over by moving my eyes to the left side where my girlfriend was sleeping next to me, and I saw my girlfriend looking at me, staring at me rather. But the most intimidating thing, the most ominous feeling, was her heavy breathing on the back of my neck.
Are you serious?
Oh my god. There was another night recently in which I felt the exact same thing, where I woke up in a panic. I had some kind of sleep paralysis, I guess, and then I was able to just look over to my left at my bathroom door, which was open, and my girlfriend was standing in the door frame staring at me. I don't know how to explain this, and honestly, I'm just glad that you're up right now with this show late at night, because the previous calls that you've been getting over the past several days, Al, I just feel like there's something wrong with this town.
Well, Brian, I'm glad that you came to me out of all people to discuss this on the radio station. I would like for our drivers on the road to feel safe and comfortable as they travel by our little town, in which I am ever so grateful to have a radio station here, stretching down to the capital and the northern canyons. But it sounds like, Brian, these past few nights have really spooked you, and I'm sorry you had to experience that. But if you felt it was right in your heart to let your girl go, then that's your call. No regrets. You can only please some of the people some of the time. And if you ever feel as though you might be threatened, Brian, or anyone else that is listening to this radio station, remember you may contact our helpful and proactive law enforcement here. They are some good people. I'll give you their number. Are you ready? Get ready. Okay, here it goes. You can call 911 and they'll provide you with the services that you need. Now, folks, one of the ways I like to kill time is by watching someone in particular on Twitch. Check out Virtual Autosports. Really neat Twitch channel there that revolves around the Forza franchise. For those of you who like to game or watch others play, it's a very neat channel. Check it out. Virtual Autosports. Now let's make way for Bob Crosby and the Bobcats.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live in my hometown.
Honestly, I'm getting sick of these calls coming in being more and more frightening and negative each night. The police cars that passed by earlier with their lights on running code, I'm sure they were responding to some unforeseen and now unforgettable event that took place in this trepidatious town. I have a bad feeling about tonight, and I am usually one of the first ones to know about bad news and sometimes good news, so I can't inform the public. I'll be expecting a phone call here. Oh, what do you know? That's probably law enforcement. You've reached 97.1 SPR. As I talked to Officer Reynolds, who was on the other line, Officer Reynolds informed me that David was killed. David, that just called in earlier, just three songs ago, the one that requested we play Sinatra, he was mutilated, torn to shreds. At least this is what Officer Reynolds told me. But how? This can't be. I just spoke with him. I know Officer Reynolds is not playing a prank on me. I remained quiet on the other line as Officer Reynolds waited for me to respond to acknowledge. 10 seconds of silence passed by before I muttered a breathtaking response. Jesus Christ. Officer Reynolds, me and him have known each other for about 4 years, and he told me a while back that he enjoys listening to this station whenever his night shift is a bit slow. I'm sure when he transferred out here 4 years ago, he must have been tuned in nearly every night shift. But tonight, different story. He was dealing with a murder. Officer Reynolds explained why he called me. It was because Officer Reynolds was just listening to 97.1 when David called in, and Officer Reynolds was chuckling at David's flying saucer story. Me and Officer Reynolds were too shocked for many words on the phone, and somehow the night felt even more silent, with David's quirky character gone, deceased. Jesus, there was someone banging outside on the window on the backside of the studio. I looked at the black silhouette, and finally my eyes adjusted to verify that it was William. I would think he would try knocking on the door, but then I assumed that perhaps he did. I just didn't hear him while I was on the phone talking to Officer Reynolds. And William likely looked around to see if I was inside, and once he saw me through the window, he thought knocking on the window was best. Still, scared the crap out of me. All right, William, just one sec. I'm on the phone with the police. As I tried to enunciate my words to William through the back studio window, Officer Reynolds heard me on the other line and told me that William's body was just confirmed to be in the same vicinity as David's. Both bodies are lying in their own gore, Officer Reynolds said. I'm looking at William right outside my... I look over at William, and his face is pressed up against the glass of the window, the condensation of his breath pulsating with each exhale. William has this menacing grin on his face, his eyes fixated on me, his eyebrows bowing inwards, saliva dripping from its bottom lip. This isn't William. I tell Officer Reynolds that someone who looks like William is right outside the studio, and I think they mean to do me harm. I tell Officer Reynolds that I'm going to stay on the line, but get here as soon as you can, please. I have a shotgun, and if this thing, whoever this is, tries to break in, I will... Look, I will blow off their damn head with this thing. Get here as soon as you can. I'm going to keep the phone on the line so you can hear if they break in. I drop the phone, but still ensuring I keep Officer Reynolds connected. I grab the shotgun out of the safe quickly, as I don't want to lose sight of this person, if you can call it that. My mind thought for maybe a nanosecond that this could be William playing a prank, but I know William. He would not do this. And why is Officer Reynolds telling me that William's body is found at David's house? Oh, God. And that's when I hear the worst sound I could ever hear in this situation. This entity that looked like William just crashed through the studio window. And it stood up on its legs and slowly turned towards me with the same menacing grin and the growl. But I, even though I had a firearm, felt frozen in time. Bullets riddled through the studio window, hitting some equipment, and luckily, some of the bullets hit this deranged-looking William. Although, it was starting not to look like William any longer. Its face clenched as the rounds from an apparent handgun outside entered this thing's fleshy, pale skin. The hair seemed darker than I remember William's hair being, and the eyes looked black and sunken in. The blood trailed down the pasty cold hands, and I noticed the blood looked darker. Not your typical red blood color. This was unmistakably darker. I mustered up the courage to raise my shotgun and pointed it center mass. I don't want to kill. I want to stop this threat. But as this devilish William slowly backed up with staggering steps, dripping its own blood through my small studio, it stopped and lunged at me as if it were about to consume me. I fired and the body landed on the wood floor, feeling like a 100-pound bowling ball. It was the perfect strike to the face, for the shot spared my own life. I grabbed on tighter to the shotgun as I lied on the wood floor. I don't remember dropping to the floor while holding my shotgun, but I guess not remembering dropping to the floor while gargling on my own blood would make for a far worse scenario. I slowly planted myself in my preferred posture, a feet right side up, checked the body, deceased. I slowly stepped outside with my left hand up in the air to show that I'm not a threat and to thank whoever helped me. But nobody was in sight. I checked the road to the studio. No police car or any other car waited outside. I thought perhaps Officer Reynolds had shown up and took the shot to help me, but all was quiet. I checked the phone inside the studio. I stepped around the gruesome body, and I asked over the phone if Officer Reynolds was still there. Vacancy on the other end. I tried calling him back. No answer. I called 911, but nobody picked up. Maybe Officer Reynolds is still on his way, or any other officer. Should I really stay near the studio and wait? Or drive myself to the police station to get in contact with somebody immediately? I pondered that idea to myself for a little while. I then decided to get in my car, but as I began driving away, that recent odd feeling of the night desert I mentioned earlier formed into this feeling of absolute terror. The moonlight seemed to be consumed by darkness, and the only light I could see was from my own car. I got to the intersection of empty Highway 93, and I could take a right towards the police station and get immediate contact with authorities, but I took a left. Evade. Blow town. Get to the next one. My best bet was get onto Interstate 40 and reach Kingman. That was my idea. I started speeding, as nobody else was on the road and I was in distress. I got about 15 minutes into my drive, and then I noticed that I was tuned to 97.1. Now, of course, I wasn't in the studio, therefore nothing was playing. I don't really plan a lot of songs ahead of time, despite what I might make it seem like. In fact, I was waiting for a call to come through after the last song that I played. Therefore, all was silent on 97.1. A few moments later, I heard something come through that frequency.
Welcome back to 97.1 SPR, The Spur. All is well here in the studio on this beautiful, dark, moonless night.
It was my own voice, but I never recorded anything like this before. This was live. My hometown is doomed.
Stay on this channel, 97.1 SPR, The Spur.
Roads are the dustiest, the winds are the gustiest, the gates are the rustiest, the pies are the crustiest, the songs the lustiest, the friends the trustiest, way back home.
Back home.
The food is the spreadiest, the wine is the headiest, the pals are the readiest, the gals are the steadiest, the love the liveliest, the life the loveliest, way back, way back, way back.